During the war years from late 1939-1947, parts of the Rockingham district were utilized for military purposes. The strategic use of Coburn Sound was secured, with the almost landlocked sound protected by the placement of anti-aircraft guns on Garden Island and the mainland. The road is safe today with fiction lines and gun emplacement stations south and west were dug into the highest sand hills. On Garden Island, the first guns to be established in 1942 were located on the northwestern tip. A second complex, Beacon Battery, completed in the same year, was located at Beacon Head to the northeast corner. The two largest gun emplacements were constructed in late 1943. The complex included its own shell store, magazine, pump chamber, and powerhouse, in addition to a plotting room, command post, and observation post. In addition, on Garden Island, the commandos at Z Force were trained in jungle warfare. To serve the island, a jetty was built at Palm Beach, from which troops were transported to Garden Island. Here also, and in Careening Bay, ships of up to 10,000 tons were moored. From 1945 till 1957, Careening Bay served as the base for most of the Australian Navy's reserve fleet detachments. A light horse training camp was established to the east of the town of Rockingham. The Army also made use of the sandhills around Warnbrough Sound as an artillery firing range. Another major development in the Rockingham district has been the establishment of a naval base on the southern and northern ends of Garden Island. The idea for the establishment had been proposed as early as 1909. During the Second World War, submarine repair facilities were set up just south of Woodman's Point. The project was revitalized in 1967, and the Garden Island Causeway was begun in 1971, completed in June 1973. The support facilities were completed with the HMAS Stirling commissioned in July 1978. Growth of the area really began in 1951. The Anglo-Iranian Oil Company in London considered West Australia as a possible location for an oil refinery to process oil from the Middle East. An offer was made and British Petroleum was given 1,000 acres of land on Coburn Sound to establish an oil refinery. BHP, which began construction of a steel rolling mill in 1953, completed in 1956. And in the 1960s, Alcoa, an aluminium refinery, was completed. In order to house the workers that would be employed, the Coburn industrial site, arrangements were made to form a new city called the Kwinana City, with the refinery as its nucleus. Thank you. Although it was originally expected that most of the workers employed in the burgeoning industrial development of Kwinana would be housed in Medina, many families decided to purchase land and houses in Rockingham. To cater for the influx of population, land developers Rockingham Park Proprietary Limited developed almost 2,000 hectares of unoccupied land to the east of the existing town. In addition, to the north of the proposed housing project, there was to be a large shopping and business center built in an area named Rockingham Park. The new shopping center was opened in November 1971 and expanded in 1973, August 1978, and October 1989. It's currently under reconstruction. In 1971, new shire buildings were built and a new sporting facility completed, as well as the opening of an acute care hospital in 1976. Today, Rockingham has a population of nearly 90,000 people. It's one of the fastest growing communities in Australia. It's got the youngest population in Australia, with a median age of 31 years and an average household size 2.7. More than 65% of the population were born in Australia, with the UK being the predominant birthplace overseas. Of the workforce, almost 30% have engineering qualifications. More than 25% are employed as managers. Almost 25% of the households are categorized as high income, i.e. a weekly income of $1,200 or more. Today, Rockingham has a diverse economic base centered around defense, manufacturing, construction, property, horticulture, viticulture, agriculture, the mussel growth, fishing, retail, light industry, tourism, and commerce. Employment opportunities are diverse and plentiful, with major manufacturing, processing, and industrial development forming a complex mix of resource-based industries to the immediate north and the world-class marine precinct at Henderson. Rockingham today attracts many tourists. Activities include viewing dolphins and heritage listed sites, surfing, bushwalking, or using one of the many parks. Other tourist activities include penguin island tours, swimming with the dolphins, or visit the Maripana Wildlife Park. Very recent developments in Rockingham include the completion of the freeway extension to Rockingham, the Lark Hill Regional Sport and Recreation Complex, Lark Hill Horse Racing, the $15 million Warrnambool Aquatic Centre, expansion of the Rockingham City Centre development, construction of the Rockingham Waterfront Village, Rockingham City Shopping Centre upgrade. Thanks, dear visitor, for accompanying me on this historical tour of Rockingham, West Australia.